Oh, what is up, Fishing Lifestyle friends and really? Okay, yeah, what's up, guys? Welcome back to another Fishing Lifestyle. So today I'm with the Mitchell Eagle.
Oh yeah.
I hope you're in frame, cause I don't know.
Well, it's alright, cause they don't have to.
But yeah,
what? Oh, beast.
Okay, anyway, go subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, and
Mitchell Eagle.
Yeah, Mitchell Eagle, it's gonna be down there. But he brought me to this pond. You know, he said, Oscar, let's go fish this early morning and let's go get on some giants. He's talking about there's some 13 pound bass in here, so I'm like, yeah, let's go. And so he brought me to the pond. Let me give you guys a little look of what it looks like here.
Ratatouille.
Oh yeah, he's starting off with a rat, you already know. Now let's see if we could get on some fish. Let's get out on the water.
First cast.
All right, guys. So, yeah, I'm having the same problem here. Okay, I'll set that down. All right, so guys, so I'm gonna show you guys what I'm using. All right, so I'm using the neon popping frog. I'd have it on some 50 pound line. I don't know why it's, don't ask why it's 50, I just have it. But yeah, I'm throwing on some 50 pound line. I'm gonna go along these edges and start popping. See if anything wants to, is up early this morning and wants to, you know, come play some games with the popping frog.
Wait, are you already videoing?
Yeah.
Shit, I'll get over here. And I was gonna come up to you and be like, oh yes, I'm not fishing yet because I'm gonna win.
That's funny.
Yeah.
So what are we doing, most fish or?
Yeah, just most fish. Time we catch. Time we're out here.
You know what, guys? Hold on, I'm gonna spice things up for you guys a little bit. Never mind. I'm not gonna tell you. You guys will see. Hold on. All right, guys. So like I said, I was changing to the absolute sauce. I put on the Savage Gear, or I think this is Live Target mouse. It doesn't have the lip. I know some of you guys are like, you know, where's the lip on this guy? I got the one without the lip because I don't know if the lip makes it. I think the lip makes it like sink, or it probably makes it have a bigger wake. I don't know which one, but I'll tug on this one because it's smaller, and I gotta see if there's even fish here first. You know, Mitchell might be lying to me. I don't even know. Cause you know, Mitchell be on games most of the time, but yeah, we're just gonna see if we can make anything happen. I'm gonna pitch over this little algae patch right here. Also, on my other rod, I have a bandito bug from the Guggen baits on, in case they like go after the mouse and then miss it. So I have something to throw back in there with. I don't usually do it, but I watched a Flare video and he told me, or not me, but he said in the video that whenever you top water fishing, like if you have a Senko or something, you can just pitch it back in there right where you got the blow up and they'll eat it, because when the fish blow up on your bait, they expect it, like, you know, to fall back down or whatever. Cause so you want to, like, obviously you want to make it look as natural as possible. Throw something in there that you think they'll just, you know, look and be like, oh, that thing's, it's hurt, and go eat it. That's really what you want. But yeah, right now we're throwing top water. We were just talking about yesterday. You know, we wanna do some top water fishing. Like, we don't even care if there's algae or not. We just wanna do top water. And after top water, we'll obviously slow it down. I'm probably gonna go with a soft plastic. Like I said, I got the bandito bug on. Probably go with that next. Who knows? But yeah, Mitchell's over there still rigging up. I don't know what's his problem.
I don't have to worry about you.
Oh, he says he doesn't have to worry about me. All right, you know. Okay, whatever. I'm gonna move. Watch. I'm gonna move location. I bet you catch a fish. Oh, Mitchell's racing me over here. It looks like this is a spot right over here. By this tree, there should be some fish right here. I think that sounded like a blow. Like a blow up. Guys, did y'all see that? Right by the log. Right by the log. Oh, let's see if I can get him up here. Got him. Did y'all see that? He literally came on the log for that. That was crazy. Wow. Look at that on the rat. So the rat does work. He's got a little hole in his lip. He's been caught before. He's been caught before. He's got a hole. Not a bad day. I mean, not a bad one to start the day off on. I mean, not as big as I'd hope, but I mean, finally got on the board. But like I told you guys, I was saying, like, right next to the structure, like, y'all see this pocket right here? I don't know, y'all probably didn't see that. I don't know how the camera angle is, but I was fishing right here, right next to this tree, and you see where it's cleared around, that's where he bit. He literally, I was coming around the tree. Like, I was gonna come on this backside in between the bush and the limb. As soon as I got it in that little pocket, he just shot up. And I'm telling you, he got sideways on the tree. I really hope I got that on film. But that was cool. And you guys were like, you know, y'all probably heard the blow up and it was like, set the hook. But whenever you're fishing topwater, you always wanna wait a little after they blow up and take your bait under. So you know they have it like in gold. So you don't just wanna set the hook because they don't really have time. They don't have time to, like, you know, realize. Oh, this is a bait, or, you know, I'm about to eat this. You know, you don't want to this because they might blow up and miss it, and you might just get a hook in your eye for some. I mean, you'd be surprised what happens with light fishing. But basically, if you guys didn't see what happened, so I was like this, and right, you guys see my mouse right there, like right here, that bass bit, right behind that limb. All right, guys, so made a couple. Changes. I got the white buzz bait here going at it, and I got the 10 inch mondo worm. Boys, we only came out here for mondo, so why wouldn't I throw the mondo worm? Guys, a mondo worm, got one. It's not big, but fish is a fish, especially on this mondo worm. I gotta tighten the drag. This thing. It's pulling freaking drag over here. Not a bad one. About a 1.5. On the Googan bait.
Really?
Yeah. We about to make a Googan bait review video, bro. Y'all down?
Yeah. I don't have any Googan
bait. Not a bad one. The recording? I think I was recording. Was I recording? Yeah, I was recording. Like I said, I felt two tugs. This might have been the fish, but never sure. So we get back in there. I caught that on the 10-inch worm. Y'all already know. Jigging the worm. I wonder if this was the same fish. Oh, nope. Got one. That one's a dink. Holy. At least we know the worm's putting in work. Alright, guys. As you guys can see, we had, I mean, it wasn't a bad day, but I mean,
it was a bad day.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, technically it was a bad day, but I mean, it's just the time that we got to spend together, the time I spent with you, that's what counts.
It's all memorable.
The valuable time. But yeah, you guys saw I caught two fish on the mondo worm and one on the rat. What did you catch them on?
I caught all of them on the topwater frog, topwater bass.
he caught him on the frog. Y'all saw it wasn't a pretty good day of fishing, but we still made it work. Anyway, Fishing Lifestyle, Mitchell Eagle.
This is our first collab, guys.
Yeah, first collab, many more to
first
come.
First collab.
Hey. Hello?
Get off the phone.
Fishing Lifestyle, out.